Rap Critic. And as you can tell by that shoehorned in reference, I'm a bit of a fan of Eminem. But even I didn't know what to think of Eminem's newest album, Kamikaze, when it struck the public conscience a few weeks ago. Sure, it had incredible lyrics and pointed barbs, but it had a couple of duds on there, and some hits didn't land as hard as they could have. And while some attacks were decent enough, a lot of them felt just bitter and kinda unnecessary. Check out the Going Off podcast review if you want to know my full thoughts on the album, but if you wanted a microcosm of how I felt about it, look no further than the lead single, Fall. A song that's supposed to re-deliver all those sharp punches that we've come to expect from Eminem.
You know, everybody's been telling me what they think about me for the last few months. Maybe it's time I tell them what I think about them.
These rappers are like Hunger Games. 1 minute they're mocking Jay, next minute they get the style from Migos, so they copy Drake. And what's scary is you probably can compare me to your car, cause I'm just barely getting started. Call it trap, cause it's a total setup, hoping that you rappers falling at. Drake said, hold your head up. Kathy Griffin's time to separate the sheep from goats. Yeah. And I got no faith in your writers, I don't believe in ghosts.
Okay, I'm good. Let's keep going. So yeah, Eminem is definitely bringing his A-game with some of these punchlines. And unlike most songs which talk about haters but usually reference them in a vague, generic sense, in this song, oh, we get some specifics.
And then tell the Grammys to go and f*** themselves. They suck the blood from all the biggest artists like some leeches. So they nominate them, get them there, get a name to MC to show every parasite needs a host.
Well, damn. He even goes in on one of his most vocal critics, Lord Jamar, who infamously said in an interview that Eminem could never be anything more than a, quote, guest in the house of hip-hop. And this was his response.
In forest, Lord Jamar, you better leave me the hell alone, or I'll show you an Elvis clone. Walk up in this house you own, thrust my pelvic bone, put my feet up and just make myself at home. I belong here, clown, don't tell me about the culture. I inspired the Hobsons, the Logics, the Coles, the Sean's, the K-Dots, the 5'9".
And these are the type of confrontational lyrics that I like from Eminem. Ones that are insulting the target while making a point. Lord Jamar's over here saying, you're white, so you'll only ever be a guest in the house of hip-hop. And Eminem is like, dude, your opinion does not matter. I'm over here actually inspiring and pushing the culture forward, as evidenced by the influence I've had on so many upcoming rappers. But unfortunately, as good as those lines are, there are a couple that just kinda don't work.
One last time for Charlamagne. If my response is late, it's just how long it takes to hit my fucking radar. I'm so far away.
Oh yeah, you thought my response was late? Well, that's because I'm like really far away. I sure showed you. Also, some people said it's a reference to rap radar, but so how does that actually address the issue that Charlamagne brought up, that some of Eminem's references and responses are sometimes dated? Like that time on Rap God where he took a strange tangent about that Ray J and Fabulous beef from 2 years prior that, like, no one remembered.
Somebody tell Button before I snap, he better fasten it or have his body bag and zip the closest thing he's had to hit to smacking bitches.
And I'd give him points for using his diss to Joe Budden to call out his domestic abuse charges, but I mean,
but if I can't battle the women, how the f*** am I supposed to bake him a cake then?
Eminem is not the guy to shame others for not respecting women. And then of course there was this line.
Tyler, create nothing, I see why you called yourself a f*** bitch. It's not just cause you lack attention, it's because you worship the 12 balls, you're sacrilegious.
And, I mean, I guess. You could definitely make the argument that he was doing the sort of Eminem shock rap stuff before, but Tyler hasn't really relied on shock rap for his aesthetic for, like, at least the last two albums he put out. So again, you're late on that critique. And I think it bears being brought up. Are you still really using the F word? And you can't even use the excuse that it's just an insult you use for anyone you don't like in that instance, because the punchline is directly about him being an F word. And yes, I am saying F word instead of the actual word because, I mean, look, we both probably shouldn't even be saying it anyway, but, you know, YouTube's algorithm with the whole demonetizing anything that references people's orientation, it's stupid. Of course, Eminem's uncensored video on YouTube also edited out that one word. But of course, in his case, he could have completely avoided that by, you know, not taking cheap shots and, like, actually addressing Tyler's critique, which he doesn't really.
If you're gonna critique me, you better at least be as good or better. Get all the hood is wetter, whatever his name is, to help you put together some words, more than just two letters.
And no one's ever accused Tyler the Creator or Earl Sweatshirt of being simplistic rappers, so that retort doesn't even work. And apparently the reason behind this diss is because Tyler said in an interview that if you still follow Eminem, you drink way too much Mountain Dew and probably need to, like, come home from the army. I don't know, maybe not the sickest burn worth responding to. But I guess M did do a song tie-in with a Call of Duty video game, so maybe he does know his audience. Somewhere some kid is bumping this while he lip syncs in the mirror. That's who I'm doing it for, the rest I don't really even care. Dude, you definitely care. Because if you didn't, you wouldn't be responding to disses and interviews from over 2 years ago that are honestly kind of pedestrian. And maybe I wouldn't mind all these inconsistent lyrics as much if the beatwork matched his intensity, but it doesn't. It's just one cold little synth line warbling around while Justin Vernon's hook sounds like the world's first audio recording of a ghost in a haunted house. Can't hear it coming down the hallway stairs from a parking lot. It's too loud. What's too loud? I certainly hope you're not referring to the beat, because, well, it's not exactly a banger, man. It's sort of quiet and reserved. And as for the actual chorus? Like, okay, let me just tell you how I feel. Just off the rip, the dude says, "Don't fall on my face," and then repeats the same phrase, but replaces face with faith. And I'm sorry, I just can't shake the fact that the word faith sounds exactly like the way you would say face if you fell on your face and busted your lip. Don't fall on my face! Oh, whoa, whoa! I fell on my face! And I can't help but think of that every time I hear the chorus, so it just ruins the impact for me. And besides, a song like this is supposed to be carrying a sentiment of, I'm the best and you were wrong to doubt me. But a phrase like, don't fall on my face, indicates that you're not confident enough in your ability to pull something off. Your hook needs to exude the confidence that the verses have, or else the delivery overall is gonna fall flat on its... You get the idea. I'm ashamed that I even started saying it. Needless to say, a diss song shouldn't sound unsure of itself at any point. No one would listen to Hit 'Em Up if the chorus went like, grab your Glocks when you see Tupac! Or maybe we should assess the situation a little more, you know, shouldn't jump to conclusions. Overall, though, I give this song a 4 out of 5. And I know I had a lot of critiques on some of the whack lines, but there are plenty of lines that are so ingenious and witty that they outnumber and are more impactful than the bad ones. But the whack ones are still there. And coupled with the beat and the uneventful chorus, it kind of pulls down the strength of it as a full package. Well, that's the episode. And here's all the obligatory call to action stuff, because self-promotion is a necessity to stay afloat on the internet. Hit the like button if you liked it, hit the red subscribe button to subscribe, and hit the bell right after if you want to know when new episodes are coming out. Because apparently just hitting subscribe is not good enough for YouTube anymore, I don't get it. And like I said earlier, if you want to hear what I thought of the Kamikaze album as a whole, check out last week's Going Off podcast. Of course, Rap Critic merch is still available on Redbubble, and as well, if you'd like to request an album or a song for me to review, hit up my Patreon. You can make requests, get to see episodes early, and other fun stuff I get up to in between episodes. So check out all that fun stuff, and I'll catch you later.